Wow. Yeah. Hello? Been a while? It's been about 3 months since the last ReZero episode, but we're back now with a brand new episode kicking off the second half of Arc 4 and Season 2. First initial thoughts slash reactions on the episode before I go more in depth and talk about everything that happens within the episode. The episode itself was great. A really, really good waste of 28 minutes, starting back the season on a strong note. One thing to point out in this episode that surprised me was the amount of content that was added in. I did not expect for the episode 1 to go on as long as it did, and 2, did not expect for them to get all the way to the Amelia disappearance. But hey, somehow White Fox did it, and it did a great job at it. Because when I look at the episode, I feel that there isn't any missing dialogue or missing scene that could have taken away from some context within the story. Everything flows smoothly and perfectly. With all that being said, Otto the GOAT, and let's begin talking about the episode. Picking back up where we sort of left off, the pounding of Natsuki Subaru by Otto Swen. Otto furious at Subaru, he constantly hits and attacks him, trying to get him to understand that he needs to rely on his friends. When we look at Subaru throughout the all of ReZero up until this point, he had the tendency to take every problem on by himself. From Arc 1 with Elsa to Arc 2 with the Mob Beast, then to Arc 3 where he tries to fight the Witch's Cult. In the attempts to subjugate these situations, he always ended up hurting himself, either physically or mentally, carrying a very, very heavy burden that he always wants to shoulder the pain and suffering upon only himself. However, a running thing that ReZero constantly puts out is people from the outside attempting to help a friend in need, that friend being Subaru. You see this in episode 13 when Amelia wanted Subaru to explain why he's acting the way he was so she could possibly help him, but he refused and believed only he should bear this burden. Or in episode 18 when Rem was able to free Subaru from all the suffering that he had taken back during Arc 3 and be his helping hand. Much like those times, this is the same. With no Rem, his helping hand is gone and he is now back to shouldering everything himself. However, Otto won't allow that. While forcibly trying to beat his ideal into Subaru, he wants Subaru to open up his heart that has went closed because of the two cases that are shown in the anime, Roswell's shenanigans and Echidna's manipulation. He is quite hesitant to open himself back up for help, but Otto essentially tells him, yeah, they manipulated you, and yeah, you did ask for help and it turned out bad, but you never asked for me. Which creates a really touching scene with Subaru realizing the friendship between him and Otto and gives up on his selfish ways to seek help from his friend. It was a great touching scene from ReZero's second best duo. Also, by the way, Flame, if you're thinking that the first best duo is Subaru and Beatrice, it is not. Just put that out there. But anyway, after explaining the plan to Otto, Subaru then visits Roswell in his chambers. With this conversation with Roswell, Subaru offers up a bet. If Subaru is able to save the mansion and get Amelia to take the trials and free the sanctuary, Roswell must follow and help Subaru get Amelia to the Seat of King. If he loses, then Subaru must fall under Roswell's command. Simple enough, right? I don't have much to say about this particular conversation itself. However, there is something that bothers me about this conversation. I am not sure if this complaint is a web novel to light novel edit or they simply left this scene out. The problem I have with all this is the bet itself. How do we know Roswell will stay true to the bet and that goes vice versa for Subaru? In the web novel, Roswell made Subaru sign a magic contract that binds them two together and wouldn't allow either side to break free from the conditions that have been set on the bet. If they do break the contract, then it will have consequences. So that gives the bet a rock hard solid foundation instead of them just going about it word through mouth. Well, that's pretty much my only problem. There's no contract binding the two to the bet. Nevertheless, other than that, it was a good scene for the two, and also Bush Otto is funny. The scene and conversation that comes up next is with Ryuzu. Here we learn that there are four different Ryuzus keeping watch over the sanctuary. Showing the foreshadowing of these four different Ryuzus, they flash back to the moments and when we first met the other two, Ryuzu Bilma and Shima. Arma goes on to further explain the backstory of Garfield's relationship with the tomb and the trial. Truly, I cannot wait for the Garfield episode, or at least I can't wait to make the content for it. But with this conversation with Arma, we were able to get answers to questions that we might have. One being Garfield's hate towards the freeing of the sanctuary, which we now know is linked to his past with his mother, and his hate for the outside world. Overall, great conversation and lore explanation. Looking forward to seeing what Subaru does with this newfound information that he has. To move on to what is essentially the last conversation, Subaru goes in to check on Amelia. Here with this conversation, Amelia pretty much opens up to Subaru, who asked her about her past and what has been going on with her in terms of taking the trial. And she pretty much goes on to explain from a very rough memory how she used to live in the forest and she used to take care along with Puck, these people who look like ice sculptures but were actually people frozen in ice. And when you watch a Frozen Bonds movie, which is pretty much Emilia's backstory, which pretty much is a small little glimpse of Emilia's backstory, she was constantly every single day for, I forget how long it was, but from a very long period of time, she took care of these ice sculptures that were actually people. More into this conversation, we also get to see glimpses into Emilia's past, where we see her as a child along with Mother Fortuna attempting to comfort younger Emilia. But finally, after a half a season, somebody finally shows up, and that is Puck. Puck has finally appeared just to disappear. So Subaru, growing angry for Puck leaving, he attempts to, I guess you can say, strangle the amulet, but Puck out of nowhere comes out and say he has been here all along. And then there was supposed to be a conversation here, but it was off screen, this seemed. Then we take the scene to Emilia waking up and finally meeting Puck, and he quickly tells her that he is breaking the contract, and because of this, it sends Emilia into a depression and sadness, because for all her life, at least for what she can remember, Puck has always been there to help her through everything. And so for him to just out of nowhere, without an explanation, give up on her, it fully mentally breaks her down. And as Puck said, she has to rely on the only person who he believes loves Emilia almost as much as he does, which is Subaru. After Puck broke the contract and he fully disappeared, Emilia went to take a nap. She depressed, she blanked out. Eventually the morning comes and Emilia is nowhere to be found. And pretty much what happens here, which ends the episode, we have Otto's declaration of war along with Emilia's disappearance. Otto declares to Garfield within the crystal room that they are about to get ready and enact their plan, which shows my boy in a great light. I love it. That's my guy. I can't wait for this upcoming episodes. All of part two of this season of ReZero is going to be amazing. I can't wait. But then we also see Emilia runs away and hides herself within the tomb. And then we see at the end Subaru coming up and consulting her. And it seems like they're about to get ready to have a conversation within the next episode. But that's pretty much everything that happened for this episode. But I hope you all have enjoyed this video. Thank you all for watching. ReZero is back. More content coming soon. Thank you all for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe for more. And goodbye.